In this video, I'm going to show you how to add sound files that you can trigger with the mouse. So that way, you can program something like this. There are several steps for incorporating sound files with your processing project. The first thing that you're going to have to do is import the library, which is a set of functions that all work together on a specific topic, in this case it's on sound, and you do that by including the import command at the beginning of your code. And for the sound library, you need to choose import ddf.minim.asterisk. The dot asterisk is important because that means we're including all of the functionality of the sound library. We're going to have to add some additional variables to the start of our program. We're going to add an audio snippet called flush, and that's similar to having a P image called toilet. It does not change colors because it's part of the library of reserved words. It's not part of the keywords in the main code. And then we need to bring in an instance of the minim library, which we're going to call minim. So I have included a link to where I got the sound effect from. If you are in my class and adding sound effects or images that you didn't draw personally, I expect you to give credit to where you got them from. And these are royalty-free sound effects at no cost that are allowed to be used in this manner. So you can go to this site if you'd like to look for some free sounds as well. So in setup, I'm going to have to create a new instance of the minim object, which I'm calling minim with a lowercase m. I'm also adding the flush.wave file to the instance of the flush variable. And to do that, it's going to be flush equals minim.load snippet. This is a function in the minim library, and then it's just storing this wave file. In the draw section, I'm going to add a few simple things. When the code is clicked in the right area, clicking anywhere else won't work, it will run all of this code. It will turn flush now to true, which makes the animation run, and then it will rewind the sound in case you're not at the beginning of the sound, and it will then play the sound. The rewind is important if you want to be able to play the sound more than one time, because otherwise the sound player will stay at the end when the sound is finished. We don't really need to do anything with it in the function that we created called flush. We do have a reset function here now so that we reset everything, allowing you to flush it more than once. But everything else was pretty much here in the last video. So the real addition mostly occurred either before the program started, a few additions in setup, and then adding a rewind and play option in the draw section. And that would allow us to, if we were to run the animation more than once, it will work as many times as you'd like in your code.